I'm Doug, your tech support representative here at Atlantic British, and in this video we want to introduce you to the O2 sensor replacement kits that we make for the LR3. This is for the 4.4 V8 as part of our Repair and Maintenance Academy. Now what we're going to do, there are two different kits and we'll just give you a quick breakdown in a minute, but you can go online, you can access and download and make copies of this sheet, which gives you all of your different maintenance items that we list for the LR3. You'll see at the end here, we have an oxygen sensor kit, and there'll be two different kit numbers depending upon the year of your LR3. For 05 and 06, we have an OXS ENS 100, and for model years 2007 to 2009 is OXS ENS 101. So you want to make sure that when you order these sets, you tell your salesman exactly what year your vehicle is. And essentially what you'll have is two separate kits. Each kit's going to contain four O2 sensors. You're going to have two upstream, two downstream. Same with this side. You're going to have two upstream, two downstream. You'll see slight differences in the color, and they're also keyed with these notches on the side so that you can't plug the wrong connector into the wrong connector on the harness. So essentially it's just a matter of making sure you know what model year your LR3 is when you order it. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you the location of these O2 sensors and maybe a few quick tips on how to remove and install the new ones. Alright, so now that we've shown you the kit, I'm going to show you the locations of your four O2 sensors so you have an idea where to go when you're ready to do your replacement. The first where we'll start is called the upstream, and the upstream O2s are referred to that way because they are on the upside or closer to the engine than the catalytic converters. Those are the two that are going to mostly regulate your fuel mixture once the vehicle reaches full operating temperature. Now, your first unit is all the way up inside, almost a good foot above the cross member, but it is definitely accessible. If you find you can't get your arm all the way in, you can simply unbolt, take the six bolts out of the front of the front drive shaft, slide it back a little bit and over to the right, and that'll give you enough access to get up in there. Now, before we go any further, I want to show you a tool that we carry that will help you with an O2 sensor. It's essentially a socket, and you can attach either a 3/8 drive breaker bar or ratchet to it. So you can get up at different angles. You can set it up straight away. You can set it at an angle. If you need the clearance, you can go up underneath. You can also use it if you have enough clearance, in like case of the downstreams, you can actually give it a shot with a hammer, which you see this one's been done many, many times. And that'll generally break them loose and be able to spin them out. But you'll see that even in the case where this one upstream is way up and in there, and with a slightly longer handle, you could definitely get up in there, and you just simply slide that up and over the wire and drop it on the socket. And essentially, we're on. Alright, so at this point now, we've shown you how to attach the tool. It is a very handy tool to have when you're doing this. We do carry it. It is listed in our catalog. Now, your downstream on the driver's side, downstream referring to you're past the catalytic converter. And these are there to help not only monitor and help with fuel mixture, but also catalytic converter efficiency. And this is your downstream unit right here. And you just simply follow the wire back to your connector. The connectors are nothing more than a squeeze tab design where you squeeze it, grab both connectors, wiggle back and forth a little bit, and make your disconnection. Your upstream on your passenger side is a little more open because you're not dealing with a front drive shaft. You'll see it also, it's about a foot above the front cross member. Same thing, they're all the same size. They're going to be 7/8/22mm to remove. So any tool in that size will help. And then your downstream on your passenger side is actually around and past the converter and almost up between the pipe and the center cross member. Now this can be gotten out with an angled wrench. Even the tool that I showed you, you can actually take that and move it at a different angle so you can still access it. And essentially, as far as the wiring, it's just a matter of follow the wire. It's only a short tab, and all four connectors will be removed and reinstalled the same way. So when you're ready to change over your O2 sensors, and again, it is done at its recommended mileage. It is a maintenance item,
and replacing them is certainly going to improve your fuel economy and your engine performance. So call any of our knowledgeable salesmen at 1-800-533-2210, and they'll be happy to help you. Thanks for watching.